Hey guys, what's happening? Niyat here with Film Comics Explained, and today we'll be taking a look at the American Godzilla, which is a reimagining of Toho's monster series, as featured in the 1998 monster film of the same name, directed by Roland Emmerich, starring Jean Reno, Matthew Broderick, Hank Azaria, and Maria Pitillo. In the film, the mysterious kaiju was essentially the result of a marine iguana nest being exposed to nuclear testing carried out in French Polynesia during the 1960s. The irradiated reptile spent its first 3 decades of development in the South Pacific, feeding on marine life, eventually growing to a height of 450 feet and weighing over 500 tons. The extremely fast giant could reach speeds of 120 miles per hour and had the ability to breathe fire by releasing an organic flammable liquid from its throat. The creature was also able to rip into metal with its razor-sharp claws and use its jaws to squash helicopters with minimal damage. It also had an enormous prehensile tail which could be used for balance and as a means of attack, with the strength to rip through buildings. Curious by the nearby fishing ships, their delicious cargo, and the people operating them, the amphibious giant made its way up north through the Panama Canal, leaving a trail of wreckage as it proceeded further up towards the United States, before finally settling in New York City to create its nest. The creature was also not initially hostile towards humans and didn't seem that concerned with them, only attacking the ships due to their massive hauls of fish and attacking the military after they'd opened fire on it. For me, it was really upsetting to see that no time was given to understand the beast that made the evacuated city its home, and with pressure from the mayor to reopen New York as soon as possible, the military lured it in with a trap before surprising it with heavy ballistic fire. Using the city's skyscrapers as cover, it was able to survive the initial confrontation without a scratch, leading the military to cause more damage to the city than the creature itself. On numerous occasions, instead of attacking the troops that had shot it before, the creature showed an almost childlike curiosity towards them, choosing not to kill them and instead make its way to the nearest food source. As a parthenogenetic reptile, the female Godzilla was able to reproduce with unfertilized eggs, and ended up laying hundreds of these in Madison Square Garden. And although the poor beast was killed in the end by the military and had its nest destroyed, there was one egg that remained untouched, which still had the potential to wipe us off the food chain. Designed by Patrick Tatopoulos, who has had a long history working on creature effects for films like The Cave, Stargate, Pitch Black, and Underworld, the Godzilla creature was modeled around marine iguanas, with a slimmer theropodic appearance, in contrast to the bulkier, erect theropod designs featured in the Toho series. Contacted by Roland Emmerich a few years prior to the scheduled production of the film, Tatopoulos was given complete freedom with the designs of the creature, with Emmerich only requesting that it should be able to run incredibly fast, wanting to make the chase scenes with the helicopters more believable. Now, the original Godzilla was conceived by Akira Watanabe, Taizo Toshimitsu, and legendary film director Tomoyuki Tanaka as a robust, erect, plantigrade reptilian sea monster, played by an actor in a rubber latex full bodysuit. Wanting it to stand out to the plethora of Godzilla films that came before it, Patrick reimagined the monster as a lean, digitigrade bipedal iguana that stood with its back and tail parallel to the ground. Tatopoulos was also such a lover of the Jungle Book that he modelled Godzilla's chin and lower jaw to match that of Shere Khan from the animated adaptation. So much of the film has been credited towards Tatopoulos' incredible work with visual effects that Matthew Broderick's character name was even based on the famed designer.
Dr. Nico Tapopoulos.
Tatopoulos.
Dr. Nico Tapopoulos?
It's Tatopoulos.
Whatever.
I really appreciated that the special effects team under Tatopoulos not only used puppets and robotic animatronics, but they also had numerous people in baby Godzilla suits, using both these in conjunction with CGI layering to bring the creatures to life. Well, that's all for today, folks. Thanks to all of you guys who requested we take a look at the Godzilla creature featured in Emmerich's adaptation of the Toho classic. I've also covered Patrick's later creature work on the awesome film The Cave, and will leave links to this below. If there's any other stuff you'd like me to check out, please don't hesitate to ask. Also, don't forget to subscribe and click the notification icon to stay up to date on all my content. As always, it's been a pleasure. Niyat here with Film Comics Explained. Thanks for stopping by.